Epic change. It pisses me off. Puzzling. Okay, let's not panic. It's not that serious. I mean, nothing is confirmed, everything is hearsay. I'm talking about S22 Ultra Crazy Camera Island that's been everywhere on the mighty internet. You've probably scratched your head trying to make sense of it, and I'm here to say, let's take a step back. Let's see what's behind the latest Galaxy S22 Ultra rumors and leaks, first of all. Let's not get carried away just yet, okay? Are you with me? Good. So, what do we know? Or at least feel deep down. Since Samsung made their foldable phones along with their Galaxy S line compatible with S Pen, we understood one thing. The Note series was losing its differentiator. The one thing that made Note stand apart, the stylus, was becoming common to Samsung's flagship phones. I wondered whether Samsung would even revive the Note series. And guys, we still don't have an answer to that, but let's be honest. The year is coming to a close. The Note didn't show up in August, and neither in September. Honestly, with the chip storage Samsung's facing, the Note might come next year or not at all. And hey, are we really complaining? I mean, by giving the S series stylus support, the Note became redundant. It's true, those phones didn't have a dedicated slot for it. Not a major drawback, but annoying enough to make us look out for a Note. But guess what? The S22 Ultra is gonna solve that tiny little problem. Uh-huh. I have good reason to believe the S22 Ultra will house the S Pen. And to do so, it's gonna borrow Note's shape. In other words, it's not gonna be easy to see a difference between the S22 Ultra and a potential Note 22 Ultra. Samsung might decide to call the phone Note even. I mean, why not? What's in a name, you know? I wouldn't mind, and I think neither would you. By the way, don't know if you remember, but Samsung had the genius idea of unifying its phones a while ago. They even wanted to rebrand the series, but while that may cost quite a bit of money and cause quite a lot of confusion, unifying the design and capabilities isn't so bad. So, will the S22 Ultra act like a Note? Maybe even be called this one? That's very probable. With an S Pen slot and maybe even a sensor that detects when the S Pen is active and when it's back in its place, enabling features depending on its activity, with a cylindrical form factor. Quite similar to the Galaxy Note design, but not identical. See, the rear camera is believed to barely change from the S21. So, I'm thinking the same 108-megapixel main camera with two 10-megapixel telecameras, one with 3x optical zoom and a periscope one. It's gonna be a quad, no worries. So a 12-megapixel ultra-wide will finish up the set. Now, considering phone makers' obsession to shave off the extra from the camera island, two weird renders popped up. Everybody loves powerful cameras, but nobody likes the camera bumps they imply. So, a render with a P-shaped camera island showed up. Here, the bottom right corner of the previous island is obviously missing. So, we're left with a weird camera housing which reminds me of the profile of an AirPods bud, stem and all, or Dali's melting clock, only we have a melting camera here. It's odd, and it's what's making everyone flip out. Now, it's true the renders come from a reliable source, but not an exact one. The S21 Ultra renders from the same source show a slightly different camera island than the one Samsung actually chose. It's not an exact science, especially since another reliable source came with a second potential design, one that separates the cameras in two modules and closely reminds me of the Note 10 Plus. Only, that phone had the cameras a bit more flush with the body. Honestly, I don't like either camera, but let's say I'd be more comfortable with the second one. It's not that same feeling of a camera leaking, you know? How about you? If you had to choose, which would you go for? And yeah, in the end, it won't matter because Samsung is gonna go with what they think it's gonna work best. Like a big-ass screen at 6.8 inches, no headphone jack, and a central punch-hole camera. Or the 45-watt charging that's gonna return next year. Yep, after they overlooked it for the S21 series, the S20 charging feature will return. Basically, we're gonna have an upgraded S21 Ultra where Samsung is fixing the mistakes of the past and hoping to catch our interest again with an outlandish camera and bringing in the things that made Note special. It's gonna be a hybrid, definitely a different beast. But one Samsung hopes will bring all the boys to the yard with other phones out of commission, like the S21 FE. It's not 100% confirmed, but chances are we won't see a fan edition this year. Why? Again, chip shortage. I mean, when you have two main series that are flagships, the Foldables plus Galaxy S, and you want to put out a cheaper phone but with awesome performance, you're gonna go with the Snapdragon 888 or Exynos 2200. Either way, best there is, right? But with manufacturing problems, things get 10 times harder. So you have to either postpone, cancel a product, or downgrade. Downgrading is the last thing Samsung wants to do right now. Can't blame them. It would cause an uproar. So yeah, with S21 FE in the air, all eyeballs are on the late January S22 launch. I mean, some of them were on the Surface Duo too. That's Microsoft just released a dual screen, heads up, not foldable, but two-screened phone. Was it on your radar? If so, can this form factor challenge a foldable? Or has Microsoft missed the train? And what Galaxy S22 Ultra camera shape would you hate to see? Tell me below. Thanks for watching. And don't forget, subscribe and hit the bell button if you want to see more videos like this. It really means the world to us. See you guys.